Hey everyone, and welcome to AiScraper. What this tool allows you to do is, given any URL, which can be any publicly available website, extract the information you want out of it and return the results in JSON format. So the best way to illustrate it is through an example. So let me do a quick demo. Let's say you're on Wikipedia and you want to extract some information out of the Yellowstone article. This is a TV show. So let's say you want to grab the number of episodes. The way that traditional scrapers would deal with this information is you would have to provide a selector for this element or somehow in some way guide the scraper towards where this element actually is. It doesn't have any context really about the rest of the website or, you know, what is it that you want to extract. You just have to point at the exact element that you want to extract. And the problem with that is web pages change design all the time. You know, things, the structure may change. A lot of modern websites run A/B experiments. And so, you know, what I'm seeing may not necessarily be what someone else sees and so on. You get the idea. So the way AiScraper works is you simply grab the URL, you pop it in here, and then you tell it what you want. We want the number of episodes. And you hit scrape. There it is, number of episodes. What you notice here is that I didn't really provide a field name, so it kind of came up with this field name for the JSON object. Now, if I didn't want that, I could be more explicit and say I want episode underscore count. Let's say I want the season underscore count as well. Title at the front and the cast at the end. So I'm providing explicit field names for these. Like, the Wikipedia doesn't have this field name in its data structure. This is the scraper understanding the intent behind what I mean by season count and actually returning that information. So you'll see here we have 5 and 47, 547, so that's accurate. And we have the cast, and it's pretty fast. So another really interesting element about this is that we're able to transform the data in real time before it's populated into the JSON. So let's say we want the cast, but we want the cast sorted alphabetically. And let's say we want, you know, we can even get something that's not even on the web page. So let's get the description, but in emojis. And hit scrape. And there it is. We have all the information that we've requested. The cast is now sorted alphabetically, and there's description and emojis. I'm not sure if you've seen Yellowstone, but if you have, you'd probably agree that that's pretty accurate. So this is the playground section within AiScraper. This is where you can experiment with different links, experiment with field names and types and how you want your JSON to be presented and so on. Once you're ready to actually use it, you'd want programmatic access, most likely, in the form of API, and we do have an API. And in here, you can generate an API key, and there's some simple docs here explaining how the API works. This is probably the shortest API documentation that I've seen. So all you have to do is provide the API key in the authorization header. There's the scrape endpoint, that's the only endpoint, and all you have to do is provide the link and the prompt. Exactly how it was in Playground. So what I'm doing right now is I'm actually giving away 100 free credits a month to everyone who signs up. Credits reset every month. But that's enough credits to play around with the tool and understand how it works. And what I would love in response is any type of feedback, suggestions, ideas, feedback, comments, anything. I'd love to hear what you think, whether this is useful, whether, you know, you'd be using this in some project, or whether this sparks any other ideas. I'd love to hear it. So you can find me on Twitter. My handle is @pestov. That's P-E-S-T-O-V. Let me know your thoughts. And thanks for watching.